Shalom and Lashana Tova. With the high holidays quickly approaching, we begin to look toward the new year, reflect on this past year, and wonder what lies ahead for us individually, as a community, and as Jewish people. We have all been impacted by this pandemic, and some of us have experienced unimaginable hardship. Whether we lost loved ones, became disconnected from family and friends, lost a job, or are lonely, everyone's lives have been touched in a profound and long-lasting way. Immediately after Purim, the synagogue was closed and all in-person services, Hebrew school classes, and programs were canceled. B'nai mitzvahs were postponed or celebrated in a very different manner. Staff was asked to work remotely. Despite the facility being inaccessible, our community did not cease to exist. We quickly organized a task force and various committees, which were staffed with our clergy and lay leaders and volunteers, were there to assess the needs and help our community. We were committed to aggressively deal with the adversity, and it was obvious that a lot of work needed to be done. Our first course of action was to remotely start up Hebrew school classes. Shortly thereafter, we began Zooming Kabbalat Shabbat and Havdalah services, and we live streamed Shabbat services. Our clergy and the ritual committee is doing a wonderful job providing meaningful services for our community. Recently, with the improving health conditions, we began to offer live and in-person Shabbat services while continuing with Zoom and live stream services. Many protocols and guidelines have been put into place, and we mandated strict adherence to them in order to ensure everyone's health and safety. You are required to register on the CBO website and provide a health affirmation. Temperature checks are taken before entering the facility. Everyone must sanitize their hands, maintain safe social distances, and remain in their designated spaces during services. Aliyos are recited from your seat. The Gabbai and Torah reader maintain social distance. Prayer books are quarantined after their use and used on a rotating basis. These are only a few of the precautions that we have taken. Before in-person services began, the facility was thoroughly cleaned and disinfected. After each service, another thorough cleaning and disinfecting is done. For those of you that are comfortable with in-person services, you are welcome to attend. Please register on the CBO website and follow the protocols and guidelines. There are no exceptions to the rules. Live stream and Zoom services will continue for the foreseeable future. I want everyone to know that I have attended all of the in-person services, and I am 100% comfortable knowing that we are maintaining a healthy and safe environment. While we receive significant information from health organizations, the state, the United Synagogue, and our own professionals, the undertaking has been a learning curve, and we are incorporating all of these measures in order to offer in-person high holiday services. The email that you just received outlines this year's plan for the high holiday services. Please click on the link or visit the CBO website, High Holidays 2020, 5781, to make your selection for in-person services or to let us know that you will only be attending remotely. While we would love for everyone to be able to come together and pray as one community, with social distancing, it is not feasible or practical at this time. I'm asking everyone to review the various services and programs that will be offered during the high holidays and share with us your preferences. The offering will include in-person services, both within the synagogue and outside of the facility, as well as live streaming of services. If you plan on remotely attending high holiday services, we also need to hear from you. If we do not hear from you, we will assume that you will be attending remotely. Finally, space is very limited, so we ask you not to request tickets if you are unsure if you will attend. We want to accommodate everyone that requests tickets to attend. We are here for you, we want to hear from you, and we need you to commit to Congregation Bethuel. Bavakasha, Shalom Alechem, and Lashana Tovah.